of the House Republican Congress. Congressman Hensarling, thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
All right, talk to me about what's going on here. It seems like a lot of process, right? Americans would like to see this payroll tax cut go through. Let's just get the ideology out of the way here for a second. Are you in favor of or against the payroll tax cut being extended?
Oh, absolutely. Here's where the debate is today. I mean, unfortunately, since the president has been elected, unemployment has either been at, near, or above 9%. So we have to help struggling American families. And so, by and large, everyone in Congress has agreed we need to extend this temporary payroll tax holiday. Here's where the debate is. The Senate wants to punt the ball. They want to do a 60-day extension. House Republicans, frankly, this is one of the few times we agree with the president. We want to extend it for a full year. That's what the American people asked for. It's what the president agreed for. So number one, that's the first point. Here's the second point.
Yep.
House Republicans stand ready to work over the holidays, like many other Americans have to do, to get this done. So today we will appoint conferees, a conference committee, which since the dawn of the Republic is how you work out differences between the House and the Senate. But so far, Democrat leader Pelosi, Democrat Senate leader Reid said they won't do it. They won't negotiate. Our way or the highway. Here's the third and last point. Washington didn't consult with the real world. Every single business group says a two-month extension is totally unworkable. It will do more harm than good. The associated builders and contractors, the roofers, the people who actually do the payroll say you can't give people this little notice and get it done. That's why we need to do the year-long extension.
I would love that we didn't have people working on these ongoing extensions to the debt ceiling and to the budget. I mean, it's kind of, in the eyes of most Americans, ridiculous the way business is going on in Congress these days. We operate on the basis of 11th-hour decisions or 13th-hour decisions. The bottom line is
Well, isn't that the point? So shouldn't the Democrats come back and negotiate in good faith?
Is a two-month extension not better than no extension?
Well, Ali, talk to the people who actually have to do this. I mean, people need to get outside of the Beltway and talk to the small businesses who are actually responsible for this, who say it's totally unworkable. It's once again Washington not listening to the people who actually create the jobs. They say you can't do all these software changes overnight that are only 2 months. So, number one, they're not listening. And listen, the last time we had a disagreement, and listen, nobody likes brinksmanship, but we went to conference, we came up with a bill to fund the government for the rest of the year and not have a shutdown. The question is, why won't Democrats come and negotiate in good faith?
Well, let me tell you, you got Scott Brown, Senator, Republican Senator from Massachusetts, you got Dick Lugar, Senator from Indiana, Dean Heller from Nevada, all speaking out against the position that House Republicans are taking. They're saying, in fact, Scott Brown says the effort to not do this is irresponsible and wrong. So you do have people in the Republican Party. Why is there this break in the Republican Party? Who is pushing?
Well, I don't know,
Ali.
What I would say is we had some Democrats who have supported our position. So there's a handful of people on both sides. But again, it comes down to this. Do you want a 60-day extension that is unworkable, according to the people who have to administer it, which, by the way, contrary to what your lead-in says, is not $1,000. A 60-day is about $160.
No, I said very specifically, sir, Mr. Hensarling, I said $1,000 over the course of a year. It's about $90.
Okay, well,
I do get my numbers right.
Well, then congratulations.
Kind of
my
specialty.
Again, here's the problem. Again, it really comes down to this. Do you want to do a 60-day extension? Do you want to do a one-year extension?
I think we
are
all
willing
like
to work off the holidays to get this done, or are you not?
Gosh, well, I'd love to know what we're doing for the next 5 years, wouldn't you? I mean, I'd love it if we weren't even working on one-year cycles. So what happens now? What's going to happen in your mind? How does this play out?
Well, again, the House will appoint people to something known as a conference committee, which, again, since the dawn of the Republic, is how we work out differences. The question is, will Democrats show up to negotiate this good faith? I hope they do. I mean, this could be worked out in a couple of days. We could do what the president asked us to do. And again, the question is, are you going to do it for a full year, or are you going to punt the ball down the road like Washington does?
You've articulated the issue very well. I guess my question is, you are a member of leadership. Do we think that we will go into 2012 with a two-month extension or a one-year extension, or is there some chance that there will be no extension to this payroll cut?
Well, I hope that the Democrats will come to their senses and be reasonable and negotiate in good faith. I hope that this gets done. Again, I'm sorry we're in the economy that we're in. I'm sorry that the president's policies haven't worked, but almost everyone in Congress has agreed we need to do this. But the debate is, are you going to do it for the full year? Or are you going to punt the ball down the road?
So
are
if there is no movement on this,
or are you not?
If you can't get a one-year extension on the payroll tax holiday, will you and your colleagues vote against extending this for 2 months? So there's some chance that Americans may not get this payroll extension because you want to stand on principle about it being a year.
Well, it's not just being a matter of principle, it's a matter of practicality, and I encourage you again to talk to the businesses who are in charge of administering this, who says it'll do more harm than good. We're not going to vote for something that's going to do more harm than good for the economy. What we don't understand is why Democrats won't come and negotiate when they all said that they wanted a one-year extension in the first place.
You and I are both digital guys. It's 2011. You probably got a BlackBerry in your pocket like I am or some kind of device. It's not going to mess up the system that we have a two-month extension over a one-year extension. The computers, the software can handle it. I mean, I think I can guarantee you by the end of the day, you and I can both do research on this.
You ought to talk to the people who are in charge of administering this with this amount of notice, what it will do to their software, impose more cost and more uncertainty.
You believe that's the issue, that the software is the problem, that we can't extend this for 2 months?
I'll lay it out again. I've laid out three different issues. Again, if the president says you ought to do 12 months, Nancy Pelosi has said this, we don't understand why you don't do 12 months.
Right.
Why are you punting the ball down the field? That's the first question. I mean, you know good and well that the president for months and months and months have said we have to do it for a full year. Yes. Now all of a sudden we've got a 60-day bill. That I do not understand. Second of all, again, most Americans are going to have to work for the next couple of weeks. Why can't we get together, Democrats and Republicans, and negotiate this out? We ought to be able to do it in a couple of days and give the American people what they want and what they deserve.
Well, we hope that is the case. Representative Jeb Hensarling, a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you for being with us. I know this is a tough issue, and I appreciate you going back and forth with me on it.